I tried the Wan SCAIL model, and the model works well when it is about following the OpenPose pre-process frames. The video I am using is this, and the pose extracted from the video is on the right. And these are the results. This result has a low resolution and runs 16 frames per second. The second output you see here also runs at 16 frames a second, but each frame has more details due to the upscale model. The third result you see here has the upscaled frames, but also some interpolated frames. After frame interpolation, this result is running 32 frames a second, which makes it look way smoother than the previous two results we saw. I am recording this video at 30 frames a second, so you will not be able to see the difference between 16 and 32 FPS video. But I will share the result on Discord so you can check by yourself. In the program's output, I had a memory error which happened because I gave around 500 frames to process on a single run. The time taken to generate this result was around 300 seconds, and then the upscale and frame interpolation takes roughly around 100 seconds. Let's look at the files required to run this workflow. Links to the files required are given at the beginning of the workflow. This section you see here is named as Pose Extraction, so it deals with the extraction of the OpenPose skeleton, which is visible on the right side. The extraction of pose from the video requires some files. The nodes you see here are new custom nodes, and we'll need to install the missing nodes from the comfyUI manager. The documentation for the nodes are given here, and below are the required files. To keep it simple, these are just two files with options into it. The first is this YOLO file, and the file size is around 60 megabytes. Download the file and save it inside the models folder, and then this folder. This detection folder, if not present, then make it by yourself. Place the file inside. Make sure you have updated the comfyUI. Next is the VIT pose. You will need any one of these files. There are multiple variants based on the size. This letter S stands for small, and this is large. I don't know what this H stands for. Maybe huge. As per the given link, the file we need is this, with a file size of around 1.2 GB. Keep it inside the same folder. After placing both the files in the detection folder, select it here. This third option is not a file. Let it be as it is. Next is this download node, which should be downloading a file, but you do not need to do anything here. The node will take care of the required file. So that is it in this section. Upload the video and image, then bypass the below case sampler. The video I am using here does not belong to me. This is the owner of the file on Pexels. I will use a different video for this example. The video belongs to this user on Pexels. And I think this video is way faster than what we need here. I will let the image be as it is. You will need to adjust these settings if the image does not follow the aspect ratio of the video. Run the workflow to check if the OpenPose skeleton is generated properly. Make sure to keep a frame cap here. For this workflow, you can limit the frames, keep it around 81 to generate a 5-second output, which will be a 16 frames per second. To generate longer video on a single run, you need to keep this number high. Note that you will have a memory error if your system fails to process a high number of frames. The skeleton generated here is too fast in motion. Let's continue and see what happens. Below are the model files, and this torch is not compiled, so I will not be using it now. The model I will be using is the smaller FP8 model, and the link to download the models are below. This BF16 model is the larger model. If you have a 5090, then you can try this model. And this is the FP8 file I will be using on my 4060 Ti 16GB. If you have a system with a smaller graphic card, and want to run this workflow on less memory, then you will need the GGUF models, which are smaller in size. I was searching for the GGUF models and I found this file. I will see if this works at the end of this video. The FP8 or the BF16 model should be placed inside the diffusion model folder. In case you're using the GGUF model, then keep it inside the UNET folder. Next is the Light X2V LoRa used above. If you do not have Sage Attention installed, then select SDPA. But I suggest watching my Sage Attention video and having the same because it can really speed up the video generation process. So the next file is the text encoder. And if this 11 GB file is large, then go back, scroll down, go to the last file. Get this FP8 file, I'm using the same 4-text encoder. Last is the VAE, download and save it in the VAE folder. The model is selected here, then the LoRa. The VAE is here, and then the text encoder. Here you need to put the video resolution. Note that higher resolution will take more time and memory to generate an output. I prefer keeping the resolution low and then use an upscale model to increase the pixels. The note here says to keep the resolution, the height and width, divisible by 32. For such cases, I prefer keeping this, and it always helps. The nodes here deal with the image and the open pose frames. And then all goes to the K-sampler to produce the result. I ran the workflow, but then I got an error. This is due to the incorrect resolution. This should be 360. Now the workflow should work. The memory usage you see here is too high, but I think there are some mistakes. Before I started to record, I made a 10-second video. And the memory consumption was less than what you see here. There may be some memory leak which needs to be addressed. The result was generated, and the fast motion was expected. Anyways, you got the idea how it works. I have changed the video. This is way slower than the previous video, and once again, this is by the Cotton Bro Studio. The OpenPose skeleton generated looks good. I will activate these nodes and run the workflow. I am processing 161 frames, which will take around 8 to 10 minutes. Processing 81 frames multiple times is faster than processing altogether. The video generation took more than 10 minutes, and the result looks good to me. When the camera goes closer to the subject, this results in weird lines in OpenPose. I wonder if it affects the final output. I ran the workflow to find it out. The result has no effects of those weird lines, and it looks fine to me. This 160 is the first 160 frames which I have skipped in the uploaded video to get this close-up scene. This scene was in the middle of the video. I will increase this number to skip more and make the video further. From a close-up, increasing distance from the subject reveals hands and legs. It was a struggle for many models. Let's see if it works here. And it works. This could have been better though. At least it is not disfigured. So I tried the Q4 GGUF model. The remaining settings are as it was before. This is the video I am using. And this is the result. The GGUF model was around 10 GB, and the result generated looks good to me. The GGUF should work on a system with 8 GB card and a 32 GB system RAM. Let me know your thoughts on this Wan 2.1 model. I think this model did very well. I hope the video was informative. I wish you a great day ahead.